I was a little bit worried because I was looking in the cloud. I was like, oh, these guys are tired. It's going to be tough getting these guys riled up. But I thank my pastor because he sees those things that we need to pray for. You know, he sees the direction that we need to go sometimes. Sometimes we get caught up doing our own things and we get caught up in our plans. And, you know, pastor, you know, is in tune with God and he kind of directs us. Amen. That's why it's important to be on a Wednesday service and a Sunday service and any Bible studies that is available to you to be able to receive the word of God. You know, outside in the world, we're just, those things cling onto our minds. And then when we come to church, we're just like drowning in those things, right? And our hearts are right. And we're trying to be here and we're trying to do the right thing, but we're just drowning in the worldly stuff. Amen. You know, the Bible says that we're not, we're in the world, but we're not of the world. Amen. So those things of the world do cling on us. And it's like watching TV all day. And after you're spending 8 hours of TV, you try to have a conversation with somebody. It's not going to work out too good. Because your mind is focused on the movie thing. Amen? Amen? Hallelujah. I just thank God for everything he's done. You know, I was kind of, when we had the brother Batu come, I was thinking, well, God, I wonder how the people are going to have, how their week is going to be. You know, when you start talking about spiritual things, you know, and you start and start speaking the words to people and they understand, and a lot of those times that the enemy doesn't like that. You know what I mean? And the enemy will try to wage war against people who receive the word of God in their heart and start standing up for themselves and taking authority over their life. Amen. And I was wondering how the people are going to come into Wednesday service. But I thank God that everyone has come here, and I believe that God has given me a word to give to you. I just thank God for this opportunity, and I thank you guys for your support. And most importantly, I thank you for my pastor who believes in me and encourages me. Amen. If you can stand with me for the reading of the word, to give God the honor and glory that he deserves. Amen. If we can turn to 1 Chronicles 28:9. And it says, as for you, my son Solomon, know the God of your father and serve him with a loyal heart and with a willing mind. You see, God is speaking to Solomon, and he's saying, do the example that your father did. Amen? That's why it's important for men of God to be able to stand firm in the word of God and to be able to be examples in front of our children. Amen? Even though we fall short sometimes, it is our responsibility and our obligation to be able to do right so that they can see us praying and they're reading. Amen? And it says, for the Lord searches all hearts and understands all the intents of the thoughts. If you seek him, you will find him. But if you forsake him, he will cast you out forever. Amen? Let's pray. Heavenly Father, I thank you, God, for your love and your mercy, God. I pray that, God, that you remove every distraction from our minds and our hearts, oh, Father God. I pray that every emotion that is not of you, let it be removed in Jesus' name, God, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Every garbage that some have brought in, God, I pray that you take it off their backs, Lord, Father God, that they may be light, Lord, Father God, so that they're able to focus on your word and what you have for them today, Lord, Father God. I pray that everyone that has ears to hear, Lord, Father God, that they hear your word, God. Use me, Lord, Father God. Let me decrease while you increase in me, God. Guide me and use me, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You may be seated. Hallelujah. You know, last week, Wednesday, there was General Conference. We had it over the big screen. It was great. And I was, when I was watching it, I was kind of a little bit sad. And I'll tell you why I was sad. Because I've seen a lot of people there. It was a little bit different this time. So they had several missionaries and pastors up there. And each one giving their story of their testimonies of what they've seen in all these other countries and in their churches. And it's a great thing, but for me at that time, what I was thinking was that back in 2005 is when I was saved. I was in prison and I got saved. And I had a dream, and God had put it in my heart, a burden to be able to go into Latin America. So this is a dream when I first got saved. So I was ignorant of any what a church was, what denominations were, and everything. But it troubled me because I was scared about this dream. I was incarcerated, and I thought to myself, I'm uneducated. I don't know much about the scriptures, right? And I didn't know how would I even get to Latin America. How would I be able to travel as a preacher to these churches? I saw myself in Latin America. I believe it was Latin America because there were Spanish people. I was speaking in English, but I wasn't speaking in Spanish. But I was in a crowd of Spanish-speaking people. And I was scared. And I was like, how is this even possible? So I ignored the dream, right? How many of us ignore dreams sometimes, man? And so I just started getting burdened, and I just wasn't happy. And so I went to the pastor, chaplain, in the prison, and I told him about my dream. And he told me a story about himself, that he had a dream that God called him, and he was in Africa, and he ran away from the calling, and he got real sick that he almost died. Until he actually was on his deathbed, he had said, "God, okay, if you save me, I will serve you for the rest of my life." And God healed him, and he became a pastor. And then he came to the United States and became a pastor in the UPC in Milwaukee. His name was Pastor Okoya. But as I look and remembered my dream, and I remembered my calling, I looked at these guys and I looked at myself and said, I felt that I had shortcut God's calling in my life. And I felt that I was being selfish because so many years that I have lived, I've been living for myself. And I've been doing church thing, and I've been trying to be in the ministry. But when the fact of the matter is, I've been doing it my way, not God's way. Amen? I felt that I failed God, and I wasn't living up to my potentials of what he was calling me to be. And I was thinking bad. I was thinking I wasted so many years doing just as little as I can. You know, you're in church, going to church, you're praying, you're going to all these activities, but and you're being in the ministry, but you're just not giving your effort. You know, I put my life first, and then after I was done with that, I gave the leftovers to God. I don't know if you guys can understand, but this is what I was thinking. I know God has called me to preach the gospel, become a pastor, and I knew that a long time ago. And I stand here since 2009, it's 2017, I really haven't got far. I believe that I haven't been living up to my potential that God has called me to be. And I thank God that he has put me back on track, amen. Amen, yes. So, as I was thinking these things, God spoke to me. When I was watching this and I was thinking all these things, God spoke to me. And he gave me three words. He says, "Made up mine." Made up mine. And I turned to the pastor, Mark, and I said, "God gave me a word." You remember that? God was dealing with me right there. I love it when God talks to me, man. It's awesome. Hallelujah. I thank God for that. Amen. Amen. Today in this world that is so unpredictable, God is searching for people that are balanced inside this church and have their minds made up. My message today is made up mine. I was told one day by a director of a company that life is like a lifeline. If you see the lines go up and down, you're alive. If you're flatlined, you're dead. Amen? When you're up here on the top, when your line's at the top, you're in heaven. And when your line is at the lowest, you're in hell. And going through your life, you must be balanced. We will face extremities. We will face times of joy. Amen? But we need to live a life that's balanced. I'm missing a page. Yeah, right? It's weird. Hallelujah. Okay, I'm going to go on. James 1, 5 through 7 says this. Sorry, sis, I lost the page. Hallelujah. Yeah, maybe skip that. Hallelujah. No, but I believe God. See, he told me in this life because I was in my company and there was a lot of things going on in the direction that was crazy. The managers were quitting and we were getting new people. We went through about 15 managers in the last year and a half that I was here. And it becomes a burdensome for you as a worker because you gotta have to deal with this, the new change all the time, the new things that are happening. One person has a new idea and then they quit, and then another person has a new idea and starts to move these things into process, and then they quit. So it's tough. So he says to me, he's like, he believed in me and he believed that I have manager potential, and he says that I need to have a lifeline, that I have to be balanced, right? I can't be one day in heaven and the next day in hell. I can't allow the circumstances to be like a roller coaster. Take me on a roller coaster ride. Some days I'm up, some days I'm down. Some days I'm up, some days I'm down. Amen? And that's how our life is in as a Christian, right? Some days are up and sometimes we're down. See, when we're happy and we're blessing God when things are good, but when we're in the middle of a circumstances that is stressful, we forget that God is still there. Hallelujah. It takes a great leader to do great things. But like any leader, they have to learn to follow. Amen? Tonight, where is your mind? Is it made up? Even in the moment when you can't tell God is with you? How many has been in a situation where they felt, where is God? Come on. Right? Do you have your mind made up when you are stripped of all your happiness? Do you have your mind made up when your children are not serving God? Do you have your mind made up when your marriage is broken? Do you have your mind made up when you're overwhelmed with the infirmities? Hallelujah. See, it is easy to be convinced when things are going your way. But it is difficult to have a mind made up when all hell breaks loose in your life. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Today I stand here being a vessel for my God, speaking to myself and to you. Is your mind made up? Sister, can you go to Philippians chapter 3, verse 13 and 14? If you guys follow me. Hallelujah. It says, brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this thing, one thing I do. Say one thing.
One thing.
This one thing called depression. This one thing called insecurity. This one thing where I can't seem to get along with my spouse. This one thing where my children are acting up and they're not listening. This one thing I can't find a job. This one thing prayers are still unanswered. This one thing, the sickness in my body. Amen? Going back to verse 13, it said, forgetting those things which are behind. Tell yourself, forget those things. Now do it with your hand. Forget those things. Forgetting your past failures. Forgetting your past sins. Forgetting your abusive words that were spoken to you. Forgetting what your spouse has done. Forgetting the offense of others. Amen. And reaching forth. Say reaching forth. For a better tomorrow. Reaching forth to receiving your crown. Reaching forth for your breakthrough and your healings. Reaching forth when your kids turn back to God. Leo. Amen. Reaching forth for prosperity. Hallelujah. For a new beginning. Amen. And the word of God says, unto those things which are before. Say, my time is coming. My time is coming. Come on, say it like you mean it. Amen, amen, yes. Verse 14. I press towards the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Some of you need to get a hold of Jesus. Hallelujah. I have my mind made up. Hallelujah. Come on, even when you don't feel like it. Come on. Coming on a Wednesday service, all tired from work. Even when you don't feel like it, Leo. Have your mind made up. Hallelujah. You just fought with your spouse in the car coming here to church. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The devil knows when you start having doubt in your mind. When you start having doubt in your mind, he knows he almost has you. I said he almost has you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ooh, I wish someone tonight, hallelujah, would throw the chains that you've been holding on for so long. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I wish someone of you would have enough faith to break through the prisons that you've been bound for so many years. Woo! Hallelujah. Come on. I wish you would strip away all that depression. Hallelujah. All that anxiety that you've been holding on to. All those things that have been passed down upon you from childhood. Hallelujah. Strip away and cry out for Jesus. I have my mind made up. Hallelujah. Most people wait for New Year's to make a commitment or a promise or a plan. Amen? Hallelujah. But I tell you, I come today. I don't need to wait till New Year's. Hallelujah. I got my mind made up, Leo. I got my mind moved up. No mountain too high, no valley too low. I'm going to serve the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Who has their mind made up? Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Let's give God some praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We love you, God. We love you, God. Help us, Jesus, to have our mind made up, God. We thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Some of you are just this close to receive that what you've been praying for so long, this close. But what's been stopping you is you haven't had your mind made up yet. Hallelujah. You ain't hearing me. See, some of you guys need a big church event or a preacher to come for you to listen to anybody. Amen? Hallelujah. Jesus healed the sick. But when he spoke to the sick, he says, your faith has healed you. Hallelujah. There's people that can come up here or talk to you on the street to tell you about the word of God and you won't even listen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You need a certain church activity to be able to move your blood pressure up, to lift up your hands, hallelujah, to cry out, hallelujah, to get up on your feet, to dance a little bit, hallelujah, hallelujah. But I tell you tonight, I got my mind made up, hallelujah. See, if the word of God is not enough for you to get out of your seats and give your rest and worship God, hallelujah. Jesus says your faith has healed you. Hallelujah. Woo! My God. My God. Hallelujah. See, a made up mind says, I'm going to worship God in the good and the bad. Hallelujah. When my life is good and when my life is messed up, when I don't have no money to pay the bills, and when I do have money to pay the bills, I will worship God. Hallelujah. When I'm laying on my bed sick and I don't have enough strength, I will lift up my hands and give thanks to God. Hallelujah. Turn to your neighbor and tell him I'm about to have a breakthrough. Hallelujah. And turn to your other neighbor. Excuse me for a minute. Because it's going to get crazy. Hallelujah. Jesus, take full control, God. Take full control. Hallelujah. Some of you have been where you are because your mind is not made up. Amen? You have allowed your circumstances to make up your mind for you. You've been believing in the reality so long that you forgot God moves in the supernatural. Paul says in 2 Corinthians 5:7, it says, "For we walk by faith, not by sight." Amen. Like the blind leading the blind, you've been following the same old lie. Come out of that in Jesus' name. Take dominion over your circumstances and don't allow them to dictate who you are. You got to have a made up mind. Hallelujah. Do I have any believers in the house tonight? Hallelujah. Follow me with Luke 18:35-43. Hallelujah. God was put on this heart. I know I spoke a little bit about this, but man, God has been just tearing me apart with this verse. I just love it when God just starts bringing things, right? You read these scriptures several times, and all of a sudden, you just one time just start, boom, God starts shooting ideas in your head. And you start seeing that scripture in a whole new way. Amen. Can I share this with you? Is it okay? Okay. And we read, so we have a blind beggar who receives sight. Amen. And as Jesus approached Jericho, a blind man sitting by the roadside begging. Hallelujah. You ever stop at a traffic light and see a homeless man, or maybe it's not a homeless man, but you see him have a sign for change? Amen, right? Has anybody seen that? And there was this one time where I seen one by Walmart right off of Green Bay Road in Washington. And so I'm driving, and I'm coming home from work, and I see this guy, and God put it in my heart, go get this guy some McDonald's, right? So God says, God put it in my heart, go to McDonald's, and, you know, just like us, human beings, flesh. I was like, okay, I'll get him go get a dollar meal, right? Go get him two chicken for $2 right away, right? That's how we think. Messed up. Forgive me. Jeez. But I did give him some food, and it was from the dollar meal, but I did give him some food. I did obey God. Okay? So I went to him, and I went over there, and I said, I had a church card, Apostolic. I was on the other church, Apostolic something, and I gave him a church card, and I said, I know some brothers who go to the church that I go to who work construction, have their own business. Maybe you can come down on a service, and I can introduce you to these guys, and maybe they can help you have a job. Amen? And so he said, he took it, and he said, yeah, I'll come. And I've never seen the guy. And I was thinking to myself, if I was in the same circumstance and I just needed a hot meal, I'd do whatever it takes to get that hot meal. I would clean the toilets. I would get on the roof in 100-degree weather and tear off that roof, man. And I'd be a champ doing it because I know I got a hot meal coming. You know what I mean? But here is a guy that has grown comfortable begging for money, where it became his job, his career. It is easier to stay in the hole because it is harder to climb out of the hole. That is some of us tonight here, our situations that we've been dealing for so long that you have gotten used to living with it. It has become part of you. And when the opportunity comes for you to break away from it, you don't want to. When there is an altar call and God was telling you to come and you didn't come. When someone was praying for you and at the end you really didn't want God to answer the prayer. You wanted to stay in your hole. It is easier for you to stay in the hole, stay in your mess, rather than change because you have gone custom and you have learned how to live with it. Right. Oh, it's quiet in the house now. Quiet in the house now. Now you live a life unhappy, accepting the consequences as they come because you are afraid to leave your hole. You tell others how miserable you are, but you make no effort to change. Right. You tell yourself and you cry out over your temptations, but you still do them. Right. It's like eating chocolates and donuts. It feels good going down, but after you're done, you regret it. Amen? You feel guilty that you ate it. Come on, I'm keeping it real. Come on. I'm talking to some people here. If you want to stay in your hole of bitterness and remorse, stop dragging down the people who are closest to you. I said, stop dragging the ones that have to be around you all the time. I probably offended two people over here, maybe more. Stop blaming the people that are next to you for your unhappiness if you want to stay in your hole. Hallelujah. If you're serious about getting out of your hole, say tonight, I can change. I stand here tonight in the authority of Jesus Christ that you can change. Yes, you can. Tell yourself, yes, I can. You can live a life of peace. Hallelujah. You don't have to be bound by your temptation or your circumstances any longer. Hallelujah. You are the head, not the tail. Hallelujah. You've been bought by the blood of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Old things have passed away. Behold, new things come forth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Get out of the hole. Hallelujah. Mind made up. So the blind beggar heard the crowd. See, sometimes in life, you will not be able to see what God is about to do. Keep it real, right? But it takes a mind made up to stay strong. You have to feel after God sometimes when you're feeling hopeless. Hallelujah. And when you feel that nobody is going through anything like you. You're the only one in the world that's going through it. Amen. You have to be sensitive to the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. The beggar heard the crowd. I'm sure that being blind, having an ear, was his main sense of walking. Amen. He was aware of his surroundings by what he heard. Amen. And so the crowd got excited. But this was something different because he recognized something spectacular was happening. See, some of you are so deep in your problem that you're not in tune with your surroundings. You can be inside a church where the Holy Ghost is moving, and you will miss your opportunity. It's just another service. It's just a Wednesday service, you know. You know, it's just Sunday school. We can skip that. You know, it's not really important. You know, long as we're there at 11 o'clock for the service, we're okay. Hallelujah. Missed expectations. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I understand coming here on Wednesdays, we're beat up and tired and our faces like, and I get that because I feel it too. I understand. But it's a different when you have a made up mind because you come with expectations regardless of what you feel. Amen. Disregard everything that you had to deal with out there away. Throw it out and come here with expectations to receive something from God. Amen? Amen. You don't have to live in your hole. Hallelujah. You can be healed. Hallelujah. You can stop fighting those battles if you choose to. With a made up mind, you can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Amen? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Verse 33 says, the crowd told him Jesus is passing, and the Holy Spirit opened his eyes of understanding. Hallelujah. How many of you know that you can see but also be blind? I can see in his mind at the moment he told himself, I can stay in this hole, or I can get out of this hole and live a new life. Hallelujah. I can ask Jesus for help. See, there are church folks that are trying to get out of their hole, but they're trying to do it by themselves. So they make many attempts to try to get out of their hole, but they fail so many times that they just give up. And it is not upon our strength that we get out of the hole, but by His. Amen? By Jesus. Hallelujah. But this beggar knew that the situation that he was living in was not for him. And with a made-up mind, he cried out, Jesus, 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 have mercy on me. And at that moment, the key from heaven unlocked the door to his circumstances. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How many of you want the doors to be unlocked? Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You see, his first words were not, Jesus, heal me. Jesus, bless me. Jesus, give me money. Jesus, give me a wife. Husband. Help my kids. Buy me a house. A new car. No, he didn't say that. What did he say? Have mercy on me. Hallelujah. God is not a genie in a bottle where we can come to him for wishes. My God, don't you know that God is sovereign? Hallelujah. The beggar gave Jesus the recognition that is due. He is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And he knew that his sin was unbearable, that he needed mercy. Amen? Hallelujah. My God. Some of you here are hindered because you lack mercy for others. How can you expect God to have mercy on you when you can't give it? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is saying tonight, repent. In fact, repent right now. So that God would open the floodgates of heaven and have mercy on your life. Hallelujah. And those things that you've been battling, the things that you've been staring in the eye, the times that you've been fighting with the devil and going wary, hallelujah, and threw your blocks and gloves away, that time that you've been waiting for so long, for your children to be delivered, hallelujah, for your circumstances to be changed, start having mercy upon others, amen, so that you may receive it. Hallelujah. See, when you have a heartbeat of God, you will not put yourself above another. And that's the mentality we have in this world, is we exalt ourselves above everybody else. We're not servants. We want to be kings of everybody. Meaning that if I have to judge you and I have to critique you and I have to say things about you because I don't like you or I don't like the what you do. Amen? We become ourselves above everyone else. And we should be humble people. Amen? We should be equal. Amen? We should stop laughing at people's shortcomings. The Bible says that, Paul actually says this, that we have been given a measure of faith. Man, some people do not have enough faith to do the same things that we do. It's a different measure of faith. People grow at different pace than other people. We should be uplifting them, encourage them to move forward closer to the relationship of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. As we look back at the scripture, the beggar repeatedly cried, have mercy on me. Amen. Repeatedly asked Jesus forgiveness. See, he knew to be ready to accept God's gift of healing, he knew he had to be forgiven. Hallelujah. I wish God's people would get this. Stop adding all the things you have done inside the church and come to God like he owes you something. God don't owe you nothing. Hallelujah. The first verse we read, God is looking for a willing heart. Willing means ready, eager, prepared to do something. See, when you have a mind made up, you do things without expecting anything in return. This is when God blesses you. Amen? Many of us pray for forgiveness, go right back and do the same thing that we ask God to forgive us from. It's a repeated process. It's like being on a hamster wheel, right? Keep running and running and never getting anywhere. Let's come together tonight and get off the hamster wheel. And get our minds made up. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. In verse 39, we go back to verse 39. Isn't it funny there will always be haters? When you try to change or you're trying to make a difference or you're trying to do something good, there's always going to be some haters. Because they see you not what you see yourself as and not what you see yourself going to be, right, and through Jesus. They see you as your past mistakes. They see you as your past failures. They see you as what you used to do. So that they're still doing the same things and you stop doing the same things and you're going in another direction, they hate on you. Amen? Hallelujah. Can I tell you something? Some of you guys need to change friends. Many times it is friends' advice that gets us in trouble. If they are not praying for you, encouraging you, helping you to be accountable, I have to question if they're really your friends. A made up mind does not try to live someone else's life. You can't be like other people because God has designed you to be unique. God has created for you in your own uniqueness. He has a plan for you. But some of us like to live up our life according to other people, what they have and where they're at in their life, and we try to keep up with the Joneses. Amen? And we turn our back on God's purpose in our life. Is that me doing that? Trust in God, live your own life, and you'll feel true happiness. Amen? Some of you have family members that love to put you down. Why do you allow them to speak those things in your life? There are those who can't do it themselves will tell you, you can't do it. Anytime you try to move forward from what you used to be, there will always be doubters. But when you have your mind made up on Jesus, a friend that never leaves you nor forsakes you. Hallelujah. Come on, church. Come on, church. Jesus will never put you down. Hallelujah. Jesus will never judge you in a way that other worlds would judge you. People of the world would judge you. Amen? Come on. I need the church to be able to get excited because they have a God on their side who got their backs. A mind made up. Hallelujah. Grab a hold of Jesus. So the beggar says, Son of David. Hallelujah. Have mercy on me. Yeah. When you have a mind made up on Jesus, he will call you. Amen? Turn to your neighbors. Jesus is calling you. Hallelujah. Jesus on the main line. Tell him what you want. Follow me with John 15:7. And we'll go back to that, sis. 15:7. It says, if you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire and it shall be done for you. I remember when I first read this scripture, man, I try to write it on my heart so I could remember it. Remember. Now, this is not a scripture to be able to be twisted and turned, amen? This is a scripture that gives hope when there is no hope. When there gives light into the darkness of your life. Amen. That you can trust in Jesus if you know your heart is aligned with his heart. And you are attempting to live a godly life the best that you can. Amen. And you don't have selfish prayers. Amen. See, God will bless you. He doesn't bless people individually. Okay. When he blesses you, brother, he's doing it so you can bless others. And see, that's what God will do. God was unselfish. He will bless you if you were with him and he's in with you. God has got your back. Amen? That's all that does. I keep hearing it. Amen. There's a picture I used to see. I don't remember where I see it. It says, God does not take us out of the storm, but guides us through it. Amen? And you know, how many knows that going through a storm is good? Because it builds us up. It strengthens us. Amen? When we're going through the storm, we can't see the other side of the storm, right? Okay? So when we're going through the storm, God builds us up and encourages us because he knows we need that. Because we can't see the other end. And he gives us the tools. He gives us the strength. He gives us the wisdom to be able to handle what's after the storm. You know what I mean? So when you're in a storm, don't get discouraged. Call on Jesus. Have a mind made up, amen, to follow after God despite any circumstances that come your way, amen? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I have a video that I wanted to show you guys. If Ginger, you could put that up real quick. Hallelujah. Thank you.
We can point out many things that can make it inconvenient or can slow us down, but ultimately, it's on us. Next step is, not only is it possible and necessary, and it's you to live your dream, to make this greatness that you have within you become a reality, but what I've come to appreciate when you're working on changing your life, changing some bad habit, getting out of addictive situations or relationships, or working to build a dream or making a difference in our society. Here's what I discovered that happens to you in life, that you will go through things, and while you're going through them, you can't understand why it's happening to you. But after you go through it, you get back and you look at it and you say, oh, now I understand why I needed that lesson.
Fear and faith have something in common. They both ask us to believe something is going to happen that we cannot see.
The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. Now, if you know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you got to be willing to take the hits and not pointing fingers saying you ain't where you want to be because of him or her or anybody. Cowards do that, and that ain't you. You're better than that.
You have to trust the process. Walk by faith and not by sight. And eventually everything else will follow.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Made up mind. Hallelujah. Some of you guys have been beaten down so bad that you don't even know how to get back up. Some of you guys have goals and dreams, but you have allowed the life to be able to hold you back. But today, God is saying, where is your mind? Is your mind made up on me? Hallelujah. Do you draw strength from the well that I continue to flow? Life of living water. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The water that you will never go thirsty. Hallelujah. The food, the bread that you can eat. Hallelujah. From the word of God. Hallelujah. A mind made up. Hallelujah. In Joshua 24:15, it says this. And we'll finish. And if it seems evil to you, serve the Lord. Choose for yourself this day whom you will serve, whether the gods which your father served that were on the other side of the river, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you will dwell. But as for me, say me, and my, we will serve the Lord. Hallelujah. Give God praise. Hallelujah. Mind made up. Tonight you have a decision to make. To have a mind made up or to continue to live in your hope. While continue to run on your hamster wheel. Or you're going to let God's word set you free tonight. There may not be another time such as this. Hallelujah. You don't have to live like you're living. I said, you don't have to live like you're living. Have a mind made up. Fear has to leave. Insecurity has to go. Pride has no place. And laziness has no room in the kingdom of God. Because laziness will want others to give, and they never give back. Young men, young women, men, women, who have their mind made up to serve God in the church and in your community. The city of Kenosha is relying on you. Hallelujah. You want something good to happen in your home? Do something for God. You want something to change in your life? Do something for God. Which God will you serve tonight? Yourself or the great I am who can save your soul? Hallelujah. Let's come to the altar with God. Hallelujah. To find a mind made up. Repent. Reach out for your breakthrough. Hallelujah. It can happen tonight. Have a made up mind, ladies and gentlemen. Hallelujah. The altar is here. Hallelujah. Seek after God, man. Today is the day of salvation. Hallelujah. Let today be the day that the chains fall off you. Let today be the day that you are no longer disabled. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That you're no longer bound by your sin. That you don't have to be the devil's playground no longer. Let today be the day that you're free from your past. Hallelujah. From your free from your mistakes. Hallelujah. From the consequences of your wrongdoing. Hallelujah. Let today be free. Let today be the day. Hallelujah. That you mark a new chapter in your life. Hallelujah. Come to the altar. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Throw everything down in front of God. God knows that you can't do it alone. You can't get out of the hole by yourself. God's speaking to you. Hallelujah. Stop running on the hamster wheel. Hallelujah. Life has been stagnant. If you haven't had peace of God in for so long, today is the day to receive the peace of God that passes all understanding. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. I made up mine. Hallelujah.